For me, I think that in the context of South Africa, in the context of Africa, I think that a lot of the times we're operating with a mindset of scarcity. So there's not enough, and so we sort of need to take here and there to make enough. And I think that perhaps what different movements, maybe like Fees Must Fall, or Roads Must Fall, or you know, a lot of other types of fallist movements or even decolonial movements have tried to put forward, is to challenge that existing paradigm that there isn't enough, or that some must have and others mustn't have. And so for me, I think that what is really necessary, and you think I'm being very idealistic and you know hippie about this, but I think what is very necessary for us is really to get indoctrinated into a concept of justice or social justice or social equity. I mean, we can debate about the exact word, but I think that there's something to be said about operating and living and existing and raising your children and educating people and going to work and paying your maid and all the things that you could possibly do, doing that from a position of believing and living as though there were enough. So exactly what you raised about how, you know, a lot of South African organizations are struggling to find funding for the things that they want to do because the feedback is, but you've got enough, right? And so for me, it's very difficult for you know, to sit and sort of have high-level conversations when I know for a fact that if we wanted to, everybody in South Africa could live, could earn 22,000 rand a month and have a decent life, right? So in the world, we believe that for some reason we accept that, you know, everybody should have the right to, I don't know, whatever human rights, I mean, I'm struggling to get my thoughts together, but there's certain things that we believe everybody should have and everybody should be able to experience in their lives, but then we start to then mediate that based on certain things. So based on your access to education, you have the right to a decent wage, or based on whatever, you have the right to, based on your gender, you have the right to bodily integrity, right? So what we've done is we've created the system where, you know, you can't have certain things unless it's mediated by something else. And I think the challenge that I think, you know, I like to bring to the table a lot, and most of my peers bring to the table, is we say, okay, why can't we all have enough?